Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. We are in part 7 of Microsoft Azure Administrator Associate Certification playlist. So let's attend questions. We have covered up to question number 19 in previous videos. So if you are new to my channel, please you can watch from the beginning. And we do have multiple videos there, and up to 19 we have resolved the questions. So let's discuss question number 20. Your company has a Microsoft SQL Server Always On availability group configured on their Azure virtual machines. You need to configure an Azure internal load balancer as a listener for the availability group. And this is the question, and the solution also provided in the question, and we need to confirm if that solution meet our requirement or not. So the solution is that you create an HTTP health probe on port 1433. So before we have this solution or we discuss about the solution, let's clarify what the SQL Server Always On availability group is and what internal load balancer as a listener, why do we need, etc. So I'll explain this on next slide. So in this diagram we do have multiple virtual machines, Azure virtual machine. So this is a virtual machine, this is another virtual machine, and like this we do have 5 virtual machines, and each virtual machine is having SQL Server instance installed on this. So if you see, node 1 has its own instance, node 2 has its own instance, 3 has its own instance. So now what we can do in SQL Server is that we can configure the availability group or always on availability group feature, which is the SQL Server feature in that case. We can by installing this, what we can do is we can create like one instance of SQL Server as primary replica, and others would remain the secondary replica in that case. So we can configure up to 8 virtual machines having SQL Server in it as always availability group. So that's the purpose of always availability group. And always availability group is for high availability and disaster recovery solution. So it's like alternate of database mirroring. We used to have database mirroring earlier. So that's always availability or always on availability group feature is alternate of database mirroring in SQL Server. So that's the one thing. Now another thing is whenever we do have always availability and group, we on Azure virtual machines we require to have load balancer installed. So load balancer, how it works is like it is like on the failover cluster of Windows. These are all our Windows machines having SQL Server in it. So load balancer gets a front IP, and that IP any application hits on that, and that distribute the request to different SQL Server virtual machines depending on load and configuration of load balancer. So that's the work of load balancer in this case. Now next thing is health probe. So actually the Azure load balancer rules require a health probe to detect endpoint status. So we can detect if any virtual machine is having any issue, if that virtual machine health is, you know, broken or that's going down, it can, you know, detect that and send the request to another virtual machine. So that's the job of health probe. The configuration of health probe and probe response determines which backend pool instance receive new connection. So in load balancer, health probe job is to determine that which is having more load and where to send new request, etc. So I hope I have clarified in this question. Now let's move to the question again. Okay, the solution here is given that create an HTTP health probe on port 1433. So definitely we have to have health probe in place. on whatever the available port, we can configure it. But the protocol we are using, HTTP, is not required because this is internal load balancer in this case, and that's not, you know, web traffic facing. So it's going to have internal virtual machines applications will be, you know, hitting to load balancer, and then load balancer will be distributing the traffic to virtual machines of SQL Server. So instead of HTTP, this is supposed to be TCP only. That's why this solution does not meet our goal. It cannot be HTTP for internal load balancer. So answer is no in this case. Let's move to next question. Question number 21. Question is same, only the solution is different. So here they have asked, like, use set session persistence to client IP. So let's understand what is session persistence and the client IP in this case. So I'll explain on the Azure itself. So in Azure portal, when we go to our load balancer page, we have to set some rules. So in rules page, we can scroll it down and we can see that we do have this option, which is the session persistence. And we do have multiple options available here. So we are talking about client IP as per the question. Okay, what exactly the session persistence? Session persistence means whatever network request is coming from the client VM or application server to the load balancer. If it is going to VM1, it will keep going to VM1 only. So it will, it's like, you know, a sticky session or sort of that stick to, let's say, if we have virtual machine 1 and virtual machine 2 as application server, and load balancer is installed in middle, and then DB1 server and the DB2 server is there. So my mouse is not that effective, so I'm just writing this like this, and the load balancer is distributing traffic to these two, 1 and 2 server. So let's say if V1 is sending the request and it's going to DB1, so always it will be going to DB1 only, because if we are selecting the client IP, it will recognize that this client IP it will take consideration each time it will send to the same server again and again. And same will happen with another server. So we do, definitely it is an internal load balancer, so we have limited number of server, and we don't want this to be going each time on a particular server, because it depending on the load of the database server where we would like to point the traffic to. So I think this is not a good idea to have session persistence. This option would be good if we configure the load balancer on a web server. So in that case we can maintain the session activity or user connectivity with particular server. So we'll go back to so I hope it makes sense now. What is session persistence and what is the client IP? We don't need this solution as it doesn't meet our requirement, so we'll press no in this case. Let's move to next question. Question number 22. The question is same actually, and the answer or the solution is given different. So we'll read out the solution directly. You enable floating IP. So we'll go to again the Azure portal to see where the floating IP option is available. So again on load balancer page, when we scroll down, almost at the end we find the floating IP option. And if we enable, what will happen? So let's understand what exactly is the floating IP. So by enabling the floating IP, actually on Azure, internal load balancer ensures that the load balancer traffic is forwarded to the backend server using their own their private IP addresses. So and this allows the backend server in the availability group to respond directly to clients using their own IP addresses rather than the IP address of load balancer. So let's understand by diagram. If we do have two application servers, and these both servers are sending their request to load balancer, and load balancer again is having two servers, DB1 and DB2 for example. So I will say D1, D2 for short, and these are V1, V2. So in this case, what is happening is that they are sending traffic is going to load balancer. Load balancer is sending to the database server. If this is sending, this is again sending to database server. So if we enable the floating IP, the client or the virtual machine or where the database is running directly communicating to the virtual machine or the client, bypassing the load balancer. So it directly, once it is through the load balancer, it establishes the connection with the client, and floating IP enables to communicate directly. So actually that preserves the client original IP address and ensure direct communication between the client and the backend server. So the answer here is, if we enable floating IP, that meets our goal. So answer is yes. I hope my videos are informative for you. So please do like, share and subscribe to my channel, and press the bell notification icon for receiving the notification. And thank you very much. See you in next video.